will start the prayer first for Tikkunei Zohar. Ribon olamim v'adonai adonim av rachamim v'aslichot miyadim anachlo lefanecha adonai elohim v'ravotenu v'kedushav v'shtecha dorata v'shtecha aviyah v'shekrevtenu v'torotecha v'avodot ha'avodot ha'kudosh v'tad ha'lochel v'kudosot ha'torotecha ha'kudosha ma'anu ma'chayenu ma'asher afita imanu chesed gedol kadeh al ken anachlo mepilim l'achon lefanecha shetimchol v'tislach l'kol chatotenu v'avodotenu v'al yehu avodotenu v'avdilim b'nenu l'vanecha ken yi ratzon lefanecha adonai elohim v'lo'avotenu כונן את לבבינו לרתך ולאהבתך, ותקשיב את זוננו אוזניך לברנו אלו, ותפתח לנו לבבות, לבבינו הערד בסודות תורתך, ולאום בנדנו זה נחת רוח, פלקת וכזה כיסא כבודך, כרך ניחוח, תציל לנו אור מקור נשמתנו, וכל בחירתנו של זאת, ושיתנוצצו נצרות עבדך הקדושים, אשר לדע גילית, דבריך האלה בעולם, זכותם, זכות אבותם, זכות תורתם, ותמותם, ותקדושתם, עמוד לנו לבנן כאשר דברים אלו, וזכותם תאיר עננו, במה שאנו לומדים, כמר, נעים, זמירות ישראל. גן העיניי והביטל לפלות תורתך, כי אדון עיניי ייתן חומה בפי ודעת ונא לי רצון ורפי, ויגון לפניך, אדוני צורי וגועלי.
Hello everybody, we have 20 more minutes of תיקוני הזוהר. And we are in פסוק לבדבב, the verse לבדבב from תיקוני הזוהר of מעלות הסולם רבי יהודה ברנדווין. We're still in קן הציפור, we're still in תיקון 6. ועוד הם שואלים ומבקשים בזונתם וכסותם ועונה, היינו עונת זיווגם שנאמר ואשר הכסותם ועונתם לא יגרע. בין מי שישאל מזונותיי רוחני שהוא תורה מזון השכינה גם בפינה שנאמר If you don't remember last time we spoke about the whole idea of how we behave doing יום כיפור או ראש השנה when we ask for things are we really asking it because the שכינה get the pleasure of giving it or we asking it because we don't have it so this section is continue and it's saying the remain asking for מזונות for money כסותה ועונתה normally when the Torah talking about the man taking care of his wife it's a ksuta or nata v'sherata lo yechsar meaning he's gonna take care of his wife's house the wife at time of zivug time of sexual intercourse and gadim and clothing that's what it says so you take that verse and it's a and those people who praying not in the right consciousness looking for the money looking for the clothing looking for whatever belong to them שלמר בשביל כסותה ועונתה לא יקרה בין מי שיש בזרות רוחני שהיא התורה מזון השכינה but people are not really studying the Torah in the right way or looking for the Torah in the right way you know somebody can go to kolel can go to yeshiva can go that but why the why is very important והיא האם העליונה זאת בינה האם העליונה זאת השכינה בינה שלמר בה ולא אל תיטוש תורת אמך and even it's written do not leave the Torah of your mother אל תיטוש תורת אמך do not leave don't go away from the Torah of your mother meaning bina ksuta the cover meaning the clothing so kisui shel tzitzit when a person put the tefillin with tefillin this is kisui when a man wake up in the morning put the tefillin that's a kisui you cover kisui mean cover you cover your skin with a different skin which is the leather of the tefillin after all kosher tefillin has to be made all from animal skin everything even the gedim even when you're sewing it so it's all leather why that of course you know I cannot go into details but the cause of this you know you cover yourself you cover yourself with a different type of skin adamu be'emato she'ashem and you cover it with the tzitzit and tefillin shel yad you say the right hand tefillin shem mochin shel malchut besod yad ke'a which is the mochin of going to the malchut because malchut mean the yada kea the malchut is what is malchut malchut because there is no light after tzimtzum it become kea kea mean dark meaning you can see the light there and this is the yada kea some people who don't study kabbalah and study from the talmud when they read on what arm you should put the tefillin it's a yada kea they read it with kuf it's a big mistake kuf aa meaning the weak hand W-E-A-K, meaning not the strong hand that you have. But Ke'a with Kaf A-A, meaning the dark hand, which is connected to Malchut, it has to be always left. So even if you are lefty, you put the tefillin on the left. And I see some people, they put tefillin, and I'm not trying to bother the Ashkenazi minag. They sometimes do it toward them, instead of away from them. The whole tefillin, the whole Musaraf tefillin is the Akedah. It's to make the Akedah, to make the binding. So it's away from you, and also left arm even if you're lefty and שנאמר בתפילה להעניק יד טוב you know the pasuk usually you say that after you do fasting תענית it's a תפילה להעניק יד טוב pray to the poor that will cover himself with clothing but this is the secret of the tefillin because we become the ani the left column is ani the Balchut is Aniyah, doesn't get the light. Aniyah means poor. So we give the light to the Tefillin. So what is Onata? How do you give the Shekhinah? That's the clothing of the Shekhinah, is the Tzitzit and Tefillin. What is the Onata, the timing of the intercourse with the Shekhinah? What do you do for that? Onata ki b'kriyat Shema. When you do Kriyat Shema, when you do the Kriyat Shema, the reading of the Shema, it's a Zivug. Abba v'Ima b'sod Onata.
When you do the Shema, you connect Abba ve'ima, and through they becoming together, that light coming all the way down to Zachar ve'nekeva.
שיוכלו להזדבק בתפילת שמוע בשים שלום, and then they can connect in the תפילת העמידה. ואם שלוש אלה לא יעשה לשכינה, שאם אנחנו נצטרך חינם לכסף. So it's in פרשת משפטים about the slave, about Eved Kenani, slave of Kenani, or Eved Ivri, or Hebrew slave. There's different laws, I'm not going to go into it, but I'm taking the Kabbalistic meaning of it. The Kabbalistic say, V'yatzah chinam and kesef. Then if you cannot give her those three things to that shifrado that made, she allowed to live without shame from you, because you didn't take care of ksuta, onata, okay? You didn't take care of all that needed. Okay, so and then she leave you, but we are now talking about the Shekhinah. We don't talk about the woman, talk about the Shekhinah. So she will leave. V'im shalosh ele lo yaseh la Shekhinah she'im alakud yatzah chinam en kesef. So she will leave without money. En lo boshet panim, that kind of person who doesn't build the Shekhinah every day with tzitzit, tefillin, ta'amida, the Shema and study of Torah, it doesn't give the Shekhinah what the three things the Shekhinah needed. And because of that, say the Tikkunei Zohar, Chatzuf Hu, is full of chutzpah, it's full of audacity, that person. Now he explained why they're being called dogs, because they want to suck the Shekhinah out of energy, they want to receive from the Shekhinah everything they want, but when it's come to give something back, to do something, they have chutzpah. המדבר אותם לכלבים, אז אני פותח את הספרים, אין כסף משום כיסוף השתוקות שלא יהיה לו השתוקות לעולם הבא. And when we say it doesn't give her the money, money in Hebrew also comes from the word כסף. כסף can mean silver, can mean money, but they have a third meaning, לחשוף. לחשוף, לנועם זיוו, meaning in the old Hebrew, לחשוף is to wish, is to desire, is to have lust for something non-physical. That's called לחשוף. So when you say money that the Shekhinah need, מלשום כיסוף השתוקקות, meaning to have a true desire, שלא יהיה לו השתוקקות לעולם הבא, that the person have to develop a true essence of desire of עולם הבא, of the next world to come, but not in a way what's good for me. And the Zohar continue, כתוב, אין כל אלה יפעל אל פעמיים שלוש עם גבר, take another פסוק to talk about three things that the men need to do. דענו שהנשמות, what is these three things? הנשמות באות בגלגול כדלת גימל לבושים. The soul has to come in the reincarnation to fix the שכינה. Why we are here? To fix the שכינה. תקן לגימל לבושים. Three לבושים, three type of clothing we fix. שעושות גימל קווים. Those three לבושים, those three things that we fix are the three לבושים, the three clothing of the שכינה. משום זה נאמר ככסותה. That's why I say this is the cover for the שכינה, the גלגול ראשון. So another explanation, כסותה means clothing of the שכינה, or clothing is a treatment in the Torah for the woman. That's first גלגול, first reincarnation, it's the clothing. שעושות קו ימין חסד, which is right column in חסד. איש סמלתו לאורו, then the next פסוק, this פסוק is related to a poor person. This is the dress to his skin, זה גלגול שני, קו שמאל. The dress to his skin is left column, קו שמאל. במה ישכב, how he's going to sleep. This is talk about avut, when you are donate to the poor person and it's time for you to take back what you gave them, you have to remember that you have to have mercy on the poor person. But the Tikkunei Zohar is helping us to understand that there is another meaning to it. And the other meaning to that is that within that verses they talk actually about the Shekhinah, because the Shekhinah is Aniyah. The Shekhinah is actually the poor. And if the Shekhinah is poor, it's written that בבמי ישכב זה גלגול שלישי כמה אמצעי דיפרט. So we have like this. First Gilgul, first reincarnation, is Ksuta, the clothing. When you talk about clothing. Simlato is dress next to his skin, his second reincarnation, and which is left column Gvura. How he's going to sleep, the question how he's going to sleep, is third reincarnation, Kav Emtzai, Tiferet. Venem Shlosha Levushim. And this is the three type of clothing. Shlosha Kisurim Shem Shlosha Tzvaim Shem Ba'ayin. Is the three clothing of the three color in the eyes. Of course, we know we have three color. We have the white of the eyes, we have the color of the eyes, and then the pupil. Those of you who did with me face reading, right? Am I right? You know that? White, color, and pupil, three. Shem Levushim Lebat Ayin Shia Neshama. And this is the clothing for the Bat Ayin, we call it the daughter of the eye, which is the Neshama, the soul. נגיד המלכות המקבלת האורות של ג' הקווים שהם חגת וכל דה מלכות is receiving those three columns ובאלה שלושה נאמר שלוש פעמים בשנה יראה כל זרחה וראייה עושות חוכמה. It's so deep, so beautiful. And for that reason, they're also sending us to see מצוות ראייה, it's called מצוות ראייה. There is a mitzvah, one of the mitzvot is to go to Jerusalem and to look at the place where the temple is. Even the temple is not there physically, it's there. If there is no time, it's already there. Never been destroyed, never been built, it's already there. So when you look at that place and temple from Har HaTzofim or Har HaZitim, I like to go to Har HaZitim, to the top of Har HaZitim, you can see it, and then you can benefit of the Har HaZitim. But you, any place that you can see it from above, you should not go inside, because the energy of the inside of Beit HaMikdash is Malchut. And because Malchut is not being Metukan, you actually lose energy instead of getting energy. Don't go there. Don't go there physically. Better to be outside from there. So the Malchut, which is where Beit HaMikdash is supposed to be, receiving those three kolom, and that's what it say, mitzvat re'iyah, the mitzvah of seeing. Why you call it mitzvat re'iyah three times a year? Because right, left, and center. You have right, left, and center. You have to remember that. Right, left, and center. And the ayin have also three kolom. So the color of the eyes, the pupil and the white of the eyes, this is the color. The white, of course, I don't need to tell you. Right? Very simple. It's the right column. Yes? Good. I think you get it. ונגד שלושה הצבעים, this three color, שם חגת, הם שלושה הצבעים שבנר. That's why if you look at the candle, also the candle has three column. I mean, there's nothing more powerful than lighting a candle. Also, if you never light a candle, cannot make a tikkun. It's saying all the mekubalim that when a person starts feeling themselves going down spiritually, light a candle. And if you want to really light, you can say the name of tzaddik while you're lighting it. And then you activate it because the word candle is nun resh. And nun resh is neshama ruach. Neshama means soul, resh means spirit. So the ner has three type of fire. Red, white, and green. Did you ever thought about it? But if I'm shchora, sometimes it turn black in the bottom. It turn black, that's a malchut. בסוד האי שחור אדום הוא אלה של הקה שלמר בהם בייר מלאך השם אליו לבד בבד האש מתוך הסנה. If you remember that God revealed himself to Moses, how did he reveal himself? With the candle too. What was the candle? The burning bush. The burning bush was the candle of God. And the bush will never burn. בייר מלאך השם אליו בלבד אש מתוך הסנה. בייר מלאך השם אליו הרי גוון אחד. When it says that the angel of God revealed himself to him, it was one column. Yemin chesed, right column chesed. Belibat esh, within the core of the fire, mitoch asneh, from the bush, is gavan sheni. This is the second column. Ainu tiferet, he called it tiferet. He called that center column, actually. The second one is the center column. Kava emtzeshu mitoch. Vaya vina asneh boer baer shagav. And when it says that Moshe Rabbeinu saw, and he saw the bush, it keep burning, that's a left column, because fire is left column. Kav smol gvura. Vem kenegit losha zvayim shabayin. That's the three column of the eyes. Belibat esh, ze bat ayin shi malchut. So when you talk about the fire of the bush, it's the same thing as the pupil. Because what is the pupil, actually? What is the black in your eyes? Do you know what it is? It's a hole. It's where the tzimtzum take a place. They haven't thought about it. That's a receiving force. That's a receiving. So the white of the eye, that's a chesed. That's why it's white. It's giving. The color of the eyes is tiferet. Now you know how it works, even in your eyes. Every place there is three. Bezman ha'u, at that time, she ya'iru shlosha tzvayim sheba'ayin, when the three color will be shine within the eyes, which is Chagat de Chochmah. This is three column of Chesed Gvurah Tiferet, but from where? Of Chochmah. Chochmah meaning light of wisdom. Light of wisdom is coming usually from the left, strong light. Because Enayim, the eyes are Chochmah. The ears are Bina. So when we talk about the eyes, it's Chochmah. Shem Keneged Gilman Zvayim Shebakeshet. Same thing of the three colors of the rainbow. I know some of you think there is four or five. Aino Malchut Sheba, Chochmah Mitgalet. Where is eventually the light of wisdom will be revealed? Only in Malchut. But because it's Tzimtzumim and all this, that cannot be revealed. Parashat Noach, et ma'amar et kashtinat adibana, mian veritia be'orach ma nikret riyah. How do you look at things? How do you see things? With your eyes. The eyes are the Chochmah. Lizkor berit olam, to remember the covenant. Vazman ha'u nemar ki ayin ba'ayin iru v'shov Hashem Tzion. So everything has to do with the eyes. And he continue. Or ha'enayim u'amud ha'emtzai ayinu ze'er anpin. The light that comes from the eyes out is center column, which is ze'er anpin. Bat ayin ha'enu malchut u'bayit shela. We call it bat ayin. I don't know how to explain it in English. Bat means the daughter of the eye. But bat ayin also meaning the bayit of the ayin, the house of the ayin, which is the socket, which means that. Shela chochmah. Of the light of wisdom, misod kedu bechokhmah yivne bayit, because we know there is a pasuk, there is a verse that say Hashem bechokhmah yivne bayit. God will build the third temple. It say that Hashem will build the third temple with chokhmah, with wisdom. But wisdom also means light of wisdom. Bizman ha'u shitpane anan mibat bayim. Hopefully, when the cloud will be removed from the eye socket, which is where the temple is, where the left column is. So there is a cloud that bothers. Shenemar ba Sakuta ba'anan. Sakuta ba'anan, there is like, it's schach, it's like a curtain that don't let us connect. Shehu tavlun sheba'ayin, davar mebalbel et ha'anayim. It say, in the section of Bechorot, in the Talmud, that there is something called tavlul. Tavlul is like something that bothers your eyes to see everything. Tavlul sheba'ayin, davar mebalbel et ha'anayim. It's something that confuses the eyes from seeing. Again, you have to follow because Tikkunei Zohar bring Talmud, bring Torah, bring Nevi'im, everything together to prove a point here. Vezoi Romi Agdola. What is Tavlul Sheba'ayin? What is the main thing? Is it Tavlul of the Ayin, meaning what bothered the eyes to see, what bothered that left column to connect, what bothered Beit HaMikdash to be built? What is it? What it say in the Talmud? Romi Agdola. There is Rome, either Italy, or it's Russia, we don't know what it is. It's called Edom. And Edom in English is Rose. And Rose is Roja, Russia. So we don't know if, and like Russia, like evil, like wicked. We don't know if it's Russia or Syria. We don't know what it is today. Rome Yagdola, the Tikkunei Zohar call it. Rome, great Rome. Shia Klipa. This is the Klipa Keneged Bina, that bother Bina. Azash Kenagdona Bina, Telomar Lakadosh, Anu Zeram Bin. Then the Shekhinah will tell God, which is Zeher Anpin, Lama ta'avod b'chutz, v'anochi pineti abayit, ayinu ha'malchut. If you remember when Lavan came to Eliezer, Eved Avraham, and it said, Lama ta'avod b'chutz, v'anim pineti t'abayit. When Eliezer, Eved Avraham came to find a soulmate for Yaakov, when Avraham, for Yitzhak, Avraham sent him, and he came back with Rivka. I don't want to go to the story. So he'd say, why you are outside and I make the house ready for you? It's a code. Anochi ha'nemar b'yitziat Mitzrayim. Why Lavan has to use the word Anochi pineti t'abayit? The same Anochi of Anochi Hashem from the Ten Commandments. Yeah. The same Anochi for Anochi Hashem ha'motzi echa be'eretz Mitzrayim. Guys, you follow, right? Anochi ha'nemar b'yitziat Mitzrayim. Anochi Hashem ha'lokecha Hashem ha'motzi echa be'eretz Mitzrayim. Ayinu bina be'or ha'yechida. And we know that Bina is getting us out of Egypt with the light of Yechida, not the light of Chaya. You know, not the light of Chaya, with light of this. This is for today, and we will continue next week.